If you want to understand Microsoft custom data and how it's used, or less specifically, if you'd like to understand how to do deployment automation based on virtual machine templates to customize and tailor your VM build, then you've come to the right place. In this video, I'll show you hands-on how to work with machine templates and how to alter those to run commands as part of your deployment. The starting point for all this, of course, is going to be working from a machine template. If you're a developer, you might get started using Visual Studio Code with an ARM extension, but if you're an average guy such as myself, then you might favor one of the following approaches.
The first thing you might try is working from a known good configuration. That is, you can extract the template from an existing VM. To do so, pull up the VM, go to the export templates section, and then from there you can copy paste the template into your editor of choice, or you can download the template and use it with your editor of choice. You can also move it to the templates library, or you can deploy it and edit some parameters in line with the deployment. Next, you could work from the Azure Quickstart library of templates, as shown here. And this looks very promising at first, but just sampling some of these most popular templates, I found that the quality was not so impressive, let's say. Nonetheless, these templates do serve as a starting point and may provide ideas for solutions to challenges that you might face. So let's see this in action. I'm working from what's called template specs. At the time of the recording, it's still in preview. And I actually have, I have only one template here. And I'm gonna start this whole thing by deploying that template. It's version 1.1, as you can see. And then while it's deploying, we can talk about my lessons learned, and we can look at my iterations leading up to that final version, if you will. So let's click deploy. And as with any VM that you stand up through the portal, through the GUI, you get a bunch of fields, a bunch of dropdowns. What you can already see here is that the values on some of these are pre-populated. I could change them, but I'm suggested with a default. And of course, that's being pulled from my template. I'm also using product tags here. You could use different kinds of tags, maybe for tracking cost or ownership. Validation is passed. There we go. And it is now being deployed. While it's working, it's gonna take a minute or so. Let's come back to template specs. And one benefit you have here, one clear benefit, is that you have versioning here. You could version your templates elsewhere, but you could do it here if you like. So let's look at an earlier version of the same template. Let's grab version 02 and edit. And we could pretty much write the do the work here, but probably something like Visual Studio Code is going to be a better place to work from. You get all the capabilities of Visual Studio. And one of the cool things is that it will grab your default values, for instance, externalize those into a parameters file. So that makes maintenance easier as well. It's a better way of working, generally speaking. And I'll just mention that you could also deploy from here, which of course, if you're a developer, maybe that's the preferred approach. So I just wanted to show that real quick, and we'll come back to the Azure portal and we continue from there. So we're back in the Azure portal looking at the version 02, and I'm gonna digress a little bit just by showing you networking here. So using this as an example, we see port 22. So that's gonna be SSH, allows us to interact with the host post deployment. And then let's look at custom data. And I had to learn this, you know, trial and error by deploying and redeploying. And that's why you had so many versions. under my template specs, but basically what I learned was that you could use these Cloud-Init commands, but it had to be a single line, it had to be this really long string thing, and had to use a new line to kind of convert this into a workable Cloud-Init document, if you will, at the time of being applied on the VM itself. The benefit here is that everything is in a single file, right? You have a single artifact, a template. It contains everything that you need to stand up this VM. The drawback is also very obvious. The drawback is that it's going to be very difficult to maintain as you as this becomes more complex with more commands added. So in my next attempt at this, or in a later attempt, yeah, let's grab this one. And this is going to represent an iteration of my custom data, but also an iteration on, permitting traffic. So for this specific template, what I'm doing is I'm deploying a free radius server. And so I realized part of testing here is I needed to add a rule in the template to allow, you know, UDP 1812, which is basically radius authentication. Digress a little bit there. Okay, back to custom data. What I've done here now is that I've actually used the include capability of Cloud-Init to point to an external file. And you can see that's my GitHub. And basically now it pulls the instructions, if you will, from a repository on GitHub. And so that's nice. We've now externalized all the configuration. I could maintain those deploy steps separate from the template itself. So kind of neat. Let's have a look. So as you can see, I created a free radius agent, which is our product here. I started writing some instructions to remember this, to come back to it later, possibly, or just share it with my coworkers or with the world, right? Anyways, the Cloud-Init file, this maybe look more familiar to you, and not very sophisticated, but you know, this was trial and error, and this was how I eventually got it to work. You could probably do further abstraction and simplify this. But this works. But one of the things that was sort of getting at me was in the back of my head here is I'm pulling down a software bundle, as you can see here, and it's not, you know, it's not private. There's no harm in this, but it's also not public. So I was a little bit concerned that I, you know, basically allow the whole world to download our software here. And I wanted to come back and refine this. And then just an example, you have an additional externalized configuration file. So I started to host content here on the repo as well. And, you know, possibly I could host the software there just as well. So we've gone from everything in the file in the template to externalizing content, which is better for maintaining this. Now let's have a look at what's probably going to be my final version here. And edit, and let's just scroll down to custom data and see what we came up with here. So you'll find it's the same include statement as before, but I'm now actually referencing Azure storage. So we're deploying a VM in Azure, and we're getting content from Azure storage. And this is, you know, you have the benefit that this can be secured. It's all sort of local and it's extremely fast. So I created a storage account, container storage, which is, you know, blob storage, and I added a bunch of files in here. Same files more or less as on GitHub, but I'm actually now hosting our software, which is, you know, upwards 60 megabytes of content. If we look at one of these files that's been uploaded and we try to retrieve it from using its, you know, resource URL here, we get a sort of access denied error. Well, it's actually an authorization. We're not authorized to get that. We're not authenticated, so we're not authorized, right? So we need to use some form of authentication here, and I choose to work with a shared access signature token, and you could set different expirations on it. As seen here, we could generate that, could generate additional. And if we get this signature or this token and we add it to the resource URL, let's do that just to show this. And so I'll just paste in the example, and I'll add the specific file that we're interested in, which is the Cloud-Init file. And we're gonna try get this again. And now we can actually see the content, so we've authenticated. And this is exactly what the VM deployment is going to do, is going to use the SAS token to access Azure Blob Storage. So here we are, we're deployed. You see my product tags, they're successfully added. And let's look at networking. So we should see a port 22, and we should see 1812. And then if we launch this now, let's connect to the VM as it's been deployed. And we're logged in. And SO would be an account from my template. And I can see my software. Those are the bundle as well as the config scripts. So they're good to go from here. And just to show some of the additional actions, this is the include statement from custom data once it's been, you know, base64 encoded and then decoded. Here's my user or group that I added earlier. And then we can do some additional checks. Just make sure that this is actually working. So we get Docker.
So to summarize, in this video, we've seen how to create a virtual machine template, either based on a existing known, you know, working configuration, existing VM, or based on the ever-growing library that Microsoft and common users provide. And we've seen how to extend on that template, how to work with the template to, one, use custom data to run commands from that are internal to the template, and two and three, to externalize those commands by using an external Cloud-Init file. And number three would be then to have that request be authenticated, and to make sure that access to the external content, that it's authenticated and authorized.